Hey guys, what's up? In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to fold this jumping jack-o'-lantern. And it also can frown, and it can be turned into a ring, a jack-o'-lantern ring. It jumps. And special for my members, I have a version of a talking cat, and it also jumps. And for membership, there's the link. And now for the jumping jack-o'-lantern. Ready, set, here goes. So for this model, I'm going to use a 6-inch square of commie. Begin white side up and fold diagonally in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Unfold and fold to the crease. Make sure to come right to the point. And repeat. Fold this corner to here. And fold this corner. And fold these two corners to the same point. Unfold and open here, push it in and squash. And fold the flap back down. And repeat. So unfold, open the pocket, and squash, and fold back down. Unfold the flap and fold this flap so that this edge and this edge align. Unfold and repeat. Make both of those folds at the same time and pinch the corner like this. And fold it down, and open, and squash. There's the preliminary base. We're going to make a petal fold, so like half of a bird base. So if you want, you can make the pre-folds. Fold the top down. Unfold. And open here, make the boat, flatten the sides of the boat. Petal fold complete. Fold it down and fold this down like that and unfold. Turn over and fold this corner to this point, letting the flap swing down. So this is the stem, turn over, and we want to try to make the stem go off to the side like this. So this is how to do that. So we're going to reach in here and just change this fold, make it go at a little slant. That's the stem. Depending on how thick you want the stem, you can just adjust it like that. And it's going to automatically form a little pleat there. That's fine. That's going to be hidden, so don't worry about that. We're just deciding how we want the stem. So maybe like that. And there's this little paper right here that doesn't look good, so we're going to try to get rid of that by turning it over. And now open this pocket and squash. Like that. And there's the stem. And adjust it like however you want it. Okay. So, pumpkin stem done. Now we're going to unfold this flap and reach in and pull this flap out and put it on top. Like that. And repeat. So, pull the flap out and put it on top. These are the eyes. Let's get these flaps out of the way. So pull down. And now fold this flap. Okay. We want to fold not right on the point, but just about like this. This corner can land on this crease right here, if there is one. So it's like that, and same here. Okay, now open and squash. Squash it to taste, however you want the eye. It could be like this, or it could be more like that. All right, so there's the eyes. And now we're going to make the mouth. So fold this edge to the crease. Now bring these two flaps up and reach in here and take this flap and fold it down. And same here. So under here, take this flap and just turn the page down. So it's like that. I'm gonna open it so you see what it looks like. Okay, now fold this flap so that we're folding on this point and we want this edge to align with itself. So it's like that and repeat. So this line should be horizontal. And these should be right triangles, although they might not be perfect, but that's okay. They're the teeth, and teeth of monster jack-o'-lanterns aren't always perfect. All right, fold up like this. We're making the teeth, and up like this. Well, if you like it like that, there's your teeth. And now unfold and fold so that the creases go up. We're going to double the number of teeth. And fold down and back up and repeat. Okay, there's 8 teeth, and if you want it to smile, you see it smiling like that, and if you bring it down like that, it's frowning. We really don't need that many teeth. I want to take the two outside teeth and turn it into more of a smile. This is optional, so if this is too difficult, don't worry about it. This is a little swivel fold, so you lift up the edge like this and squash it like that. So again, you lift up the little raw edge and squash it. And when you squash it, you want to try to make this edge align with the other edge of the tooth. So there's the smiling jack-o'-lantern. And if you don't want it to smile, you can just take this flap and fold it down. So that way we have a little bit of a smaller mouth and it doesn't have a smile. So that way it can frown and it doesn't have any smile. So there's the frowny jack-o'-lantern. And now let's fold on these two points. We're going to shape the jack-o'-lantern. So right there and here. Like that. And turn over and fold this corner to here. And now we're going to squash. So we're folding this edge to the middle, and these edges align, and reach in and squash it. and repeat. All right, fold this flap down and back up, estimating thirds. Fiddle with the folds until the thirds are exact. Okay, so it's like that. And now pull this down. And now we're going to fold this flap up. Make sure to hold the layers together so that they don't slide. And we're folding it up so that this edge aligns with that little flap, like that. So if you did that correctly, this width should be equal to this width. So this is going to be folding in thirds. Okay, so this fold extends to about here. And repeat on this side. So we're folding this edge onto the little flap and extending it downward in thirds. All right, so we have those two folds. And now fold this edge onto this edge. Just pinch it like that and like that. So it makes sort of like a box. Like that. And we're going to collapse the sides of the box. One goes underneath the other. And it's like this. So here we have a jack-o'-lantern on a popsicle stick. And we can make it happier. Like that. Oh, and we want to make a nose. Well, first try to push these edges together if you can, so that you don't see the white, because that kind of looks bad. Okay, so if you want a nose, by the way, this is optional, so if this is too hard, just skip the nose, no problem. Okay, so those edges are together, looking nice. And now we want to make a little pleat. Right in there. Like that. And now reach in and just try to curl the paper out so that it makes a triangle. Right there. And same thing on this side. And this is tricky. There's the nose. All right, now you can just shape it to taste, round it out. All right, now we got a nice jack-o'-lantern on a stick. I'm gonna show you how it jumps, but first I wanna show you how to make a ring. Because if we make it jump and then undo the jumping thing and make the ring, then the jumping will no longer work so well. So just round it, curl it around like this, and take this flap and stick it underneath the front layer. Just wrap it inside like that. And this is the ring. And it might not fit on my fingers because my fingers are really big. There, it's on my little finger anyway. Okay, you get the idea. And now let's do the jumping. So just not sharply, just bend the paper right about at this edge. And just kind of bend it to taste. I'm not going to really tell you how to make a spring. Just make sure that you make these edges align. That's the important thing. And don't fold sharply. Okay, that's a nice spring like that. Okay, and let's see how it works. Oops. It's going to take a little fiddling to get it. There it goes. That was good. Yeah. Yeah, another thing is that you don't want to hold it down too long. You want to just bring it down and let go, and that'll make it go a little bit more. And as you continue to do it, the jumping might not stay as jumpy, but that's the nature of using origami models. Eventually they wear out. But this one looks pretty good. And it's happy and it's sad. And it can be a little inchworm. Wiggle, wiggle worm. And it also creates a nice stand like that. And it's a bobblehead of sorts. So, all right, hope you guys enjoyed folding this and have fun making it jump. Boing. And I'll see you guys later. Have a great day.